Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So it's been a while since I last did a makeup tutorial, a talk through makeup tutorial in English. So I thought today I'll do a talk through makeup tutorial for you guys. So I'm just going to create some yellow themed makeup look today, yellow eyes and nude lips that would match my background and my ugly looking nails. So I am yet to do my nails. We will do that later. Okay, I'm just giving them a break. Please ignore them if they look ugly. So now without any further rambling, let's just get started. So first thing, I have to moisturize my lips. I'm using my purple lip balm. This is a decent lip balm. It just keeps your lips moisturized for quite good amount of time. Okay, lip prep is done. I'm going to prep my face. I have already applied toner and serum earlier in the morning. I'm going to moisturize my face right now. I'm using my Neutrogena Hydro Boost Moisturizer. Now, so many of you guys have asked me a review on this particular product. I would say I totally love this. If you are on the extreme oily skin side, definitely give this a try, especially for the summer time. No, this is super light in weight. This gets absorbed into your skin super fast and also gives you this nice soft texture to your skin and also keeps your oil at bay for a longer period of time. So I'm not going to apply any SPF right now because I am going to film further videos after doing this. So I'll be removing it however, so I'm not going to apply any SPF. But if you are going to apply makeup and if you are doing your base, then don't skip SPF. Now I'm going to move on with my primer. For primer, I'm using my Master Prime by Face Studio. This one is the Maybelline's primer. I'm using this to create a nice blurry smooth effect on my skin. This actually works great for any skin type. This is a white cream based primer. It does not do a good job in covering up your pores, but actually gives you this nice smooth canvas for your foundation to go on. So for today's look, I'm going to skip the one part that I usually do after my primer. I'm going to use a concealer instead of a corrector. I usually use an orange corrector to hide out all my hyperpigmentations and dark spots. I still do have them. But today I decided to use this concealer from MAC. This one is the 24 Hour Smooth Wear Concealer in shade NW45. This has like a nice orange undertone to it. So whenever I use orange corrector and NW45 on the top, my look kind of turns a bit orange. So I decided to use only this one today. I'll see if it's not working, then I'll go ahead and apply some more orange corrector. We will see. So I'm just applying this on the areas wherever I apply my orange corrector, like usually on the hyperpigmented areas, like around my mouth, on my dark spots, underneath my eyes, and on the temples. This concealer dries fast, so you have to blend it out fast as well. So I'm using this tiny little sponge from PAC. This one is the mini beauty sponge variant. So you can use this if you want to specifically target any area to spot correct or to fill in the areas with concealer or foundation. So I'm just using this to blend the concealer into my skin. Okay, we will just move on with our foundation. For foundation today, I'm using my Nykaa's Skin Shield Anti-Pollution Foundation in shade Mighty Mocha. I'm running out of my makeup, guys, like the base products mainly. I just wanted to purchase, but I'm not in a mood to purchase because it just takes time and I don't really want to bother the courier guys, to be honest. I feel really very sorry when they travel around and roam around, you know, but it's their job, they have to do. So I'm just waiting for everything to get under control. And my residential area is not completely safe right now, so I don't really want to do any online shopping. So I'm trying and using the things that I actually want to finish up, but I really don't want them to get over as well. I don't know. Also guys, do me a favor, just comment down below the products that you want me to try, like the makeup products mainly, the foundation, concealer and powders and things like that, that are specifically available only in India. I don't want to do any international shopping right now. So just let me know the products that you want me to try and share my thoughts and reviews on it, like the makeup products basically, not the skincare ones, because I right now have a handful of skincare products. I don't want to try anything new as of now. So I just wanted to try some different base products mainly. You can definitely let me know in the comment section below. I'll add them in the cart and I'll purchase them as soon as I can so that I can make videos on them for you guys. So I'm just going to conceal and highlight my face. I'm using the same MAC 24 Hour Concealer in shade NW45 and NC45. Now, NW45 is slightly on the neutral undertone and NC45 is lighter than NW45 and warmer than NW45. So, I'm using the NW45 to directly cover all the dark spots and the darkness underneath my eyes, like the direct under eye area, and I'm quickly blending it out. So whenever I'm working on the under eye area, I'm like concentrating the sides of the eyes area as well, the area where my nose and eyes, you know, meets this part. So I'm just making sure that that part is concealed properly as well. I'm just making sure that everything is like properly concealed and nice and neat and good looking. I'm going to slightly highlight my face. As I said earlier, I'm using the NC45. I'm working this on the center part of my cheeks, like that, underneath my eyes, and I'm quickly going to blend it out. I'm also highlighting the bridge of my nose and my forehead a little bit. So now I'm going to set the concealed areas with some powder. I'm using my Maybelline Fit Me compact powder in shade 330 Toffee Caramel. Toffee, just toffee, not caramel. I'm using the same sponge, taking the powder with the sponge, and I'm going to press this on the areas where I have concealed. My sponge is like in the most disastrous condition, but it's okay, it's working good right now. That's it for now, but I'm going to slightly bake my under eye area. Also, the bake is just going to make sure that my under eye area is not going to catch any pigments from the fallouts when I do my eyeshadow part. So I'm taking my RCMA loose powder and I'm just going to place some loose powder underneath my eyes. I'm also kind of applying this on the sides of my nose, also making sure that my nose is a bit snatched. And again, I'm using the same powder to set the bridge of my nose. This is just going to brighten up the bridge of my nose, make it look highlighter. So I don't really want to use any specific contouring technique to make my nose look snatched. Also using the same loose powder to cut my jawline area. This goes right underneath the area where I'll be bronzing. So once after I bronze and add blush, now that area will stand out. So I'm just going to fill in my eyebrows when the powder is setting. So I'm using my Makeup Revolution Graphite Eyebrow Pomade, like the usual one, and nothing has changed in my eyebrow routine right now. If it changes, I'll let you know. I'll update you on that. Okay. My eyebrows are done roughly. If I want to retouch it up, I'll do it at the end. I'm going to move on with my eye makeup right now. So after a long time, I'm using a proper eyeshadow base. This one is the MAC Soft Ochre. I'm just going to apply this on my eyelids today, just so that it would work as a good eyeshadow base. But you can just apply your normal concealer and powder for this step. So today for my eyeshadow, I'm using my Makeup Revolution Sofix Collaborated Eyeshadow Palette. This one is the Extra Spice variant. So I'm using this shade. This is Vitamin C from this palette. I'm using this shade on my transition. So now we have got a low on both of our eyelids. So next I'm going to use this shade, this one. It's called Romance. It's a beautiful yellowish shimmery shade. I'm going to work this on the lid part. No, this is not Romance, this is called Larsen. I'm working this with my fingers, just applying this on the centers. Let me know if you are an yellow lover. I mean, I don't love yellow, but I like yellow. I'm just slightly going to intensify the outer V part and the upper part of my lash line with this shade. This one is called Chocolate Orange. I'm taking this shade in a small defined pencil brush and I'm going to slightly work this on the outer V and on the upper lash line, very slightly, just to give like a small dimension of color. I'm taking the same Larsen and I'm working this on the inner tear duct area, just to highlight this part. So now I'm also going to apply the same Larsen, the shimmery yellow one, on my lower lash line. So I'm taking my Genvoy Bay liquid eyeliner. I generally like to use liquid eyeliners when I have to draw some precise, nice winged liners. So I'm taking this eyeliner and I'm going to do some winged liner today. Okay, I'm going to clean up the wing area. So before that, I'm just going to remove all the excess powder from my nose and the under eye area. Now I'm just cleaning up the wing area with some concealer. Also guys, if you have made this far, just right now go ahead and comment down your favorite color in the comment section so that I just know that you guys are keeping up with me till now. I'm going to prep my upper lashes by giving a good coat of mascara. I'm using my Milani Bigger Lashes Mascara. I'm using Chestnut from Early Girl to bronze my face, and this is a beautiful orange toned pressed powder. So it's not that you have to use only a proper bronzer to do your bronzing job. If you have any powder or any compact that has bronzer undertone to it with which you would like to bronze your face, then go ahead and use that. And that's the reason why I use Chestnut today for bronzing my face. I'm going to fill in mascara on my lower lashes. I'm using the same Milani mascara for my lower lashes as well. I'm just going to finish my blush part. I'm using the Sugar Blush Kit and I'm taking this mauveish pink shade. So there it is, a nice mauveish pink blush for the look. You can also do a peachish blush for this look, it would go really very well. Now I'm going to highlight my face. For highlighter, I'm using this highlighter from Focolure. This is in number 4. This is in shade name called Spoon. This is a nice rose goldy highlighter. The rose flecks are very minimal, so you won't see much of rose blinging, but it's a good golden highlighter. I'm also taking the teeniest amount with my finger and working this on the tip of my nose just to give a small hint of highlight on my nose. So now I'm going to take the same highlighter and I'm going to highlight the inner corner of my eyes. Also, I'm taking the same highlighter to highlight the highest point of my brow bone area just there, and I'm like blending the corners with my fingers. Now for the lips, I'm using my Rich Chocolate Lip Liner from Maybelline. This is like my favorite lip liner if I want to go for like a good nude color. Okay, so I ended up filling in my lips with the lip liner. So just to mute it down and to make it look like a good nude color, I'm going to use this hack. I'm taking my concealer. You can use whatever concealer you use. Something that's like very close to your skin tone. I'm taking my Wet n Wild Dark Cocoa. I'm taking this with my fingers and I'm working this on my lips. Don't freak out, this is not going to ruin your lips, okay? And it's definitely not going to dry down your lips as well, because you have your lip liner underneath with it, which is just going to be moisturizing on your lips. And the lip liner is going to make this blending easy as well. I'm just going to apply this lip gloss from ColourPop. This one is the Ultra Glossy Lip Gloss from ColourPop. The shade name is called Free Spirit. This is a limited edition one. I'm just working this on my lips. So guys, that's it. If you want, you can go ahead and spritz some setting spray on the top of this. That's just going to melt your face. I think I'll just spritz a tiny bit of setting spray on the top of this. So this one is the Grand Finale Setting Mist from Sugar. Just going to spritz this on my face. If you really want your makeup to look more skin-like, then go ahead and spritz makeup setting sprays. That is just going to save your makeup game. But personally, I like that powdery matte looking effect on my skin. So even after the setting spray is dried, at the end I'll slightly touch my face with some powder, and that is what I go for. That is what I like, and for my oily skin, that's what actually works if I want my makeup to last all day long. So that's it guys, this is my final look. This is completely out of my comfort zone. I don't know, I'm playing with different colors and different techniques with my eye makeup look. If you guys are watching my channel and me for a while, you guys should know this, because I mostly have kajal on my eyelids. I barely leave them just like this. But for today's look, I decided not to touch my kajal, and this is what I came up with. I don't know how many will like it, but I personally love how the look turned out. I specifically wanted my lips to be soft and nude because I want my eyes to pop more just with the yellow and the eyeliner that I have given. With that, the video comes to an end. I really hope you guys like today's video, like today's look, and also grab small tips and techniques that I shared in the video. If you like this video, please give this video a thumbs up and let me know what your favorite color is. Don't forget it. My favorite colors are, because I have so many favorite colors, gold, bronze, olive green, royal blue, orange, black, white, gray, brass, copper, maroon. I have so many, okay? I have so many, and it just changes with time. Okay, with that being said, I would like to complete and close today's video. I hope you guys liked this video. If you like this video, please give this video a thumbs up, and I will see you all in my next one, guys. Bye.